Hey there, Nick Lee here from Pragmatic Works, coming at you again with another video all about Power BI. And in this video, we're gonna be talking about working with survey data. Yes, we're talking tables that have multiple columns of questions and answers beneath them. So this doesn't necessarily just correlate to survey data, but it does correlate to survey data the most. I would say this is one of the most common examples of this type of solution being implemented. So we're going to be working with survey data. And the big problem with survey data is that it is great. It works great. You collect all this data from surveys, you know, like maybe the answer of number one being the least satisfied and the answer of five being the most satisfied. But you collect this data maybe from Microsoft Forms or maybe elsewhere, and you bring it into Power BI and you try to do some reporting on it, but it doesn't really work right. And we need to actually fix this up. We need to data shape this in such a way that makes it not only better for performance, but also ease of use for reporting purposes. So that's the goal today. Take data that's akin to survey data, make it much more usable and user-friendly and performant, and utilize that in Power BI. And we're gonna do it all within Power BI here. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump over to Power BI and work on it and see what we could do.
Before we begin, want to learn more about Power BI? Visit prag.work/nick40 and you'll get a 40% discount on an annual on-demand learning subscription, and you'll get access to over 100 courses. Now onto the video.
So here we are in Power BI, and I have a couple of visuals on screen here just to show as some examples of my survey data and how it works. But first, let's tab over to our table view to see what this data looks like. So as you can see, I have a few different columns here that are descriptors, like respondent ID, age, gender, country, education, employment, etc. And then I have five questions. Now, all of this data was made up by me. It's just a very much example data. And, you know, my product is so good that I have no ones as answers, okay? So it's technically only 2 through 5, all right, guys? So bear with me on that. So anyways, so we have five questions. And as you know, survey data may be as simple as 5 questions, or it could have 30, 40, 50 questions involved with it. And this solution is gonna work with any number of questions that you have, okay, guys? So that's the goal here. And the goal here is be able to make this a little bit more usable. So our goal here is to make this as usable as possible. So how are we gonna do that? So let's go back to the report view and actually take a look and see what it looks like right now in its current state. So I have a couple of examples on screen here. And, you know, just to kind of show kind of some of the problems you'll see while trying to report on this data as it currently stands. So let's start off by looking at this left matrix I have on the screen. I have country as rows, and I have a count of respondents or kind of people who answered this. And we're going to see, like, all right, well, what are their answers? How are we going to look at it? You know, what did they get? So if we're looking at it here on this left table, it doesn't really make a ton of sense what it's displaying. So for the country as rows, that looks fine. But the columns, I have question 1 through question 5 as columns, but it's saying 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, one thing we know about this data is that even though I have 5 questions in the column section, it's only showing the actual values from that column, which is 2, 3, 4, and 5, because no one answered 1 on this particular survey for any of these things. So it's actually just pulling in, you know, it can't be right because, you know, if I have 5 questions and 100 records, because that's how many respondents I had in this example data here, exactly 100. If I have five questions and 100 respondents, then how is it only displaying, you know, 100 total responses here? It's because of how this matrix visual is utilizing the current columns that exist in our data set. And as you'll notice, there's actually a hierarchy that's built in, an ad hoc hierarchy here. And if I expand this hierarchy out, now you can see it gets a really crazy with all the different questions that we have here. And it actually doesn't make really any sense at all. We have all these different totals that are happening in the column headers, and then our countries down here on the bottom, they're kind of giving you some crazy numbers here, and it shouldn't be this complicated, but it looks awful and it's really, really hard to utilize here, okay? So that's one example of how you would utilize the data in its current state. And as you can see, it is not great. So let's just look at one more quick example here. This is basically the same thing, just inverted, where the questions are in the rows and then the country is in the columns in this case. and you could see it's hierarchical once again. And if I drill into this hierarchy, you could see it's kind of doing the same exact thing in the left visual, except it's doing it at the row level instead of the column level. And it's just very hard to read, and it really doesn't make any sense at all. So we're gonna fix this up, okay guys? We're gonna fix this up. So how we gotta fix this up is essentially, we need to kind of turn the table on its head, so to speak, or at least a couple of the columns. So what we're gonna essentially do is take all the questions that there are in individual columns and unpivot this data. By unpivoting it is we're taking a subset of columns and making them actual record values as rows. So this will duplicate our data, but that's okay. And the reason why that's okay is because Power BI works so much better if it is a thinner but longer table. And in this case, we're gonna be eliminating most of the columns that come from the questions. And then we're going to be adding rows. Now, this is totally okay. Now, because if we do this for all five questions, it's gonna give us, instead of 100 records in our table, it's gonna give us 500 records on our table. And if we had, you know, 30 questions in our survey, it would turn our 100 record table into a 3000 record table. And that's, again, 100% fine. There's no issue with that. And in fact, Power BI will still probably, it could very well perform better, as well as be more responsive and user-friendly if we changed it from those, you know, 30 question columns to, 30,000 records rather than like 100 records. And it's crazy. It's kind of hard to understand that, but this isn't a video where I'm going to go into the whole compression algorithm and how it works and so on, but just take my word for it. Okay. Thinner tables are better than wide tables. So just keep that in mind, and the record count doesn't really matter. I've had tables that I've worked with before that have been, you know, like 10,000 records that performed worse than tables that had millions or 10 millions of records, just because they were much thinner tables, and it just naturally worked better due to the compression algorithm. Okay, so take my word for it on that. So let's do that. How do we do this unpivot I've been talking about? Well, we're gonna go ahead and click on this transform data button at the top in the home tab to launch the Power Query Editor. And once we're in the Power Query Editor, now we can do some heavy transformations on this table. And how we're gonna accomplish this on pivot is we're actually going to go over to the questions columns, and I'm gonna highlight them. I'm gonna start with question one and go to question five. And again, you would do this for however many questions you have or however many columns you're trying to unpivot. And you're going to right click any of those column headers, doesn't matter which one. And you see, if we go to the bottom, there are three different options. There's unpivot columns, unpivot other columns, and unpivot only selected columns. And you could do this in any number of ways, but for the method that I'm doing right now, where I have these question columns highlighted, we only want to unpivot the columns that we currently have selected. So I'm gonna click on that, all right? So we're gonna unpivot only selected columns. And now you can see on the bottom left of the screen, there is eight columns with 500 rows rather than, you know, 11 columns with 100 rows. So we essentially eliminated three columns and made them this attribute and value column instead. Now you can see in this attribute column, all of our questions are listed here. And in the value column, all of the corresponding answers are listed there. So before I do some renaming on here, there's a little bit of cleaning up I want to do. When I display my questions now in this kind of format, I don't need to know which question number it is. All I care about is what is the actual question itself. And to do that, I'm going to do a quick little down and dirty transformation here. I'm going to right-click this attribute column. I'm going to choose split column by delimiter. And Power BI is pretty smart, and I knew it was going to do this. It gave me this kind of saying, oh, you want to split a column by delimiter? I see a underscore. Do you want to split it by the underscore? And in fact, yes, I do. So I wanted to split it by the underscore, hit OK. And now it's split this column up. It basically got rid of all those Q numbers in my attribute column. Now I did just delete this attribute.1, and now this looks so much better. So now we're gonna go ahead and rename these columns. I'm gonna call this attribute column, maybe questions, and I'm gonna rename this value column to maybe something like responses. So that looks pretty good. I'm really happy with how this data looks now. Even though it's much longer, it's thinner, it's gonna be way easier to report on. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose close and apply. And this is gonna break these two tables here, and that's fine. I don't care about these things. Get out of here. I'm gonna delete these. All right, so now that I have that done, I'm going to create a new visual that's going to work with this. So I'm going to add a matrix just like I was doing before. And for rows, I am going to look at questions. And for columns, I'm going to look at responses. So check this out. So I have 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, we know that the responses are only 2 through 5. No one actually answered one or anything, and that's okay. And then for the values itself, I want to see, all right, how many people answered 2, 3, or 4, or 5? So I'm going to drag over this respondent ID column to the values section, and notice Power BI is going to automatically know I'm going to count it. And this looks really good. Well, what if I want to look at the country level now? Well, that's very simple. I could take this country column and I could drag it down to rows and kind of make a hierarchy in the rows themselves. I could drill down in the hierarchy here, and now I could see all the different answers per country. And if I wanted to look at something else, I could drill back up and maybe, you know, maybe I could look at, you know, gender instead of country. You know, it all depends on how you want to kind of display this information here. So this makes sense. All the numbers add up correctly. I'm expecting 500 total responses because each responder answered, you know, 5 questions, and there's 100 people. So therefore it gives us all 500 as our grand total. And this works great. It's so much easier to use. It's very easy to see. It's easy to utilize. And it's all because we unpivoted that data. And like I said, it's a win-win. Not only is it easy to report on, but also it's more performant. It's going to be faster. So there's no reason not to set up your data in this type of way. If you're using data that is survey data or similar to survey data, when you could really unpivot that data down and make it look so much better and easier to use. And now this is going to work great for many different types of visuals. You could use bar charts or you know, tree map visuals or whatever it is you want to use to be able to kind of track this stuff. So that's it, guys. That's all about, you know, data shaping survey data or survey like data, and, you know, being able to unpivot that data, make it to where it is way more consumable, way more performant. You are going to get a lot of mileage out of using this methodology in the future. You know, once you start recognizing your data that may be able to be benefited by something like an unpivot, your data shape is going to be so much better. Your data model is going to be so much easier to report on, and you're going to have better performance. And it's all wins from here on out once you realize how to really to make the most out of this transform called unpivot. That's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and stay tuned for more videos coming from me on this channel, and I will see you later.